just like we did in the compressor, what we did, we basically raised the pressure from certain value to the certain value. Just opposite of that, we are having the expander kind of arrangement. That expander, what it will be doing is it will be reducing the pressure from certain value to the certain value, and because of the reduction in the pressure, it will rotate its shaft, and that shaft will be connected to your compressor, so it will be able to run your compressor. So this is my expander. Let's see what is the composition in the case of, see, in the case of the expander, we are having only methane, ethane, propane. So I have removed these components. Now fluid package will be the same. Go to the simulation environment. Now can you see this? Do you wish to left in the holding mode when entering the interactive simulation environment? See, if you are in the simulation environment, now from the simulation environment you went to the component list and you have done some changes either in the component list or you have changed the fluid package, and again when you come back to the simulation environment, it will pop this message: do you wish to left in the holding mode or entering the interactive simulation environment? The meaning of this message is, since you have moved from the simulation environment to the component list or full package selection, now you have done certain changes in that, either component list or full package, you have done certain changes. Now you are coming back to the simulation environment. It is asking whether your solver, you wish to be in the holding mode. Holding means if you say yes, then it will not calculate. It will not calculate the streams condition if it is there inside the sims environment. It will not calculate. If you say no, then it will say, it will automatically calculate. Let's say I am saying that yes, I said yes, then now you can say you are on the on hold mode. You are on hold mode. Note, see this one, on hold mode. Now I am saying that we have done changes again. We have removed it. Now we want to move to the simulation. Yes. Remove. It will ask only once. Now your solver is on hold mode. On hold mode means even though if you provide the composition of the stream, like your temperature is 25 degrees C and the pressure is 20 and the flow rate is 250. Now composition is 0.5, 0.3, 0.2. Since even though you have defined the streams, you have defined the temperature, pressure, and the flow rate as well as composition, but it is not solving because your solver is on hold mode. Now you will have to change to the active mode. Now it will calculate. Now you have provided the component and selected the thermodynamic package. Now you have defined the streams. The second option is, now is either you define one material stream, take and one energy stream and connect it, your energy stream and your outlet stream. One inlet stream is one. One option is either you provide the, just like compressor, either you provide this expander outlet pressure from here and provide the efficiency over here, or we will see one more thing here. Efficiency is 30% and my outlet pressure is my outlet pressure is 5 kg. Outlet pressure is 5 kg. Now it has converged. The second way of doing this is, you have not entered value from here. Now go to the compressor and go to the worksheet tab. What many people are doing is they are preferring to go to the worksheet tab and define all the condition over here. Many people used to define the condition by clicking on that stream and then connecting it to the compressor, and other people are preferring to go to the worksheet tab, then define over here only. You can define from here also. So instead of it should reduce to 5 kg. So there is no harm in doing this. You either you go to the outlet stream and define your condition and define your compressor efficiency, expand compressor efficiency or expand efficiency by clicking on the equipment, or go to the worksheet tab, go to the worksheet tab and define from here. So these two are the options by which you can perform this activity. So in the case of the expander, our objective is to reduce the pressure from
5 kg. Excuse me, sir. Yes. So one question. Sir, can we say that expander and a turbine one and the same thing?
Yes, it is almost same thing. Same thing.
Okay. See,
when actually you will be having, see, when you are having any plant flow sheet, plant PFD, P90, and you want to simulate your entire plant in the high seas, okay? So in high seas,
yes.
In high seas, there is no such kind of thing that turbine is there. So what turbine is doing there? It is handling high pressure stream, and reducing its pressure, means HP stream to HP stream.
Yes, sir.
So you will take expander and whatever the steam turbine inlet condition is there in the plant, that condition will be your expander inlet condition over here. And since you know what is the turbine, my turbine outlet pressure, that pressure you will take over here as the expander outlet pressure.
Okay.
So again, just like turbine, the turbine outlet steam, let's say we are having the HP to MP steam, we are having certain limitation that my pressure should not go beyond this value. So there is also some limitation, since and that pressure is corresponding to certain temperature also. So see, in this case, since we have reduced the temperature pressure from 20 to 5 kg, and because of that expansion, thermal expansion has expansion, cooling has taken place, so temperature I'll reduce from 25 degree C to 5 degree C. So in actual case, initially your plant will be designed based on this temperature, like minus 5. So based on this temperature, your MOC, material of construction of those pipeline who will be handling this fluid, that will be selected. So if you will reduce the pressure from, instead of 5, let's say you have reduced the pressure to 1 kg. Now your temperature has reduced from minus 5 to minus 27 degree C. So there will be certain limitation that if you go to 1 kg pressure, your material of construction, your metallurgy of that pipeline will not be suitable, will not be able to handle the fluid at this much low temperature. So these kind of limitation will be there. If you are working in revamp project, again I'm saying, if you are working in the revamp project, then revamp, you will not propose your client to invest that much amount in which he can have a new plant. So the purpose of the revamp project is you have to suggest a modification in your client's plant by using the minimum to minimum investment. Maybe if you will reduce the pressure to 1 kg, since your temperature will reduce to minus 27, and because of that low temperature, your downstream equipment's metallurgy will not be able to handle those things. So what you will do? Ultimately, you will have to replace all the pipelines. So that is not recommended to do. Now, your compressor, then this expander. Same kind of information will be here also. Single curve, again, if you have the curve, means revamp project, then vendor will have to provide you the data like flow versus efficiency curve, molecular weight versus molecular weight versus efficiency, molecular weight versus flow, pressure versus flow, all those curve client will provide. So when the client will provide all those information, we can also simulate, we can also provide all those information in the compressor. See, many times, leave it, because this is the part of the dynamic simulation, and while doing any EPC company, people are not doing the dynamic simulation, so we will not. We will be here only design, connection, parameter. Then, if you have the ready information, then you will provide this. Then, worksheet tab. See, in the rating curve, if you are doing the rating of this equipment, then you will be adding these curves. You will add these curves, and you know for the curves you will be having certain value x versus y, x versus y, x versus y. So all these information, all these head versus power, volume versus mass, efficiency versus efficiency, all these information that will be available in your curve that has been provided by the equipment supplier. When you will be doing the rating activity, then you will be doing. Else, if you are working in EPC company and you are working for the new designing for the new equipment, then again you will be limiting that my inlet stream is having this much pressure and my outlet stream should be at this much pressure and this much temperature. Temperature here also is very important. My outlet stream temperature should not go down beyond certain value, like minus 5, minus 10, whatever is it. Here we will specify that temperature also, that my outlet temperature should not go beyond this value. This is very important. Otherwise, he will select even much lower temperature then entire metallurgy, entire pipeline MOC or metallurgy have to be changed. That is not recommended. Any doubt in this expander? Anybody have any doubt?
Do we use this dynamic simulation for troubleshooting the plant operations?
See,
is it used for that purpose?
Yes, see, the purpose that as we have discussed that in dynamic simulation, what we are doing is we are able to see the behavior of the system with respect to the time, how the, let's say, composition, how the pressure, how the flow is changing with respect to the time. All those things can be seen in the dynamic simulation, how the things are varying with the temperature. But in steady state, we are not able to see. We are just seeing the inlet condition. And once you change the inlet condition, you are just seeing the final output condition. So that as far as dynamic simulation is concerned, the dynamic simulation activity is being performed mostly in the OTS company, that is operator training simulator company. So in OTS company, what we are doing is the OTS model is developed when your plants, all the information like all the plants equipment data, all the plants equipment data is available, all P90, PFD, HMB is available. So once all the information is available with us, then we proceed for the dynamic simulation. In the dynamic simulation, just like in 10 to 15 minutes, we did the simulation of this expander. And likewise, in 10 to 15 minutes, we did the simulation of the compressor. In 10 to 15 minutes only. But if you are doing the dynamic simulation activity, then even for simulating one compressor will take at least one day. Because you will have to input all the parameters like head versus flow, efficiency versus flow, and all those things, all the data you will have to provide in the simulation. Then again, if you are doing that here, see state number one, if you can see in state number one is directly going to the expander, and now outlet stream, that is my outlet stream two, is again just going from the expander. If you are, there is certain rules for doing the dynamic simulation. There will be at least one valve at the battery limit. Means if we were supposed to do the dynamic simulation, then what I had done, I had taken the stream number one, then I will have added one valve here. Then I will have added one more stream, let's say, for example. We were doing the dynamic simulation. What we will be doing, we will be having one inlet stream. Now this is three, this is this one. Now, what this valve will perform, this one will offer certain resistance, will offer certain pressure, right? So if when you will be doing the dynamic simulation, then when we were doing the steady state simulation, then you will go to the parameter and you will opt here, you will say that delta P across this valve should be this much. So there will be certain value. And this valve should allow this much of flow, right? But when you are doing the dynamic simulation, in the dynamic simulation, you will have to go to this rating tab and you will provide this delta P, how much delta P we are allowing to this valve, and then it will size your valve. This, the window which you are seeing right now, all these things we are using in the dynamic simulation activity, but not using this in the steady state. As you know, the valve which you have used here, this valve may be linear. Now that things comes when you will be doing the dynamic simulation, then in that case, not only you will be having the expander or compressor data sheet, you will also be having this control valve data sheet. So you will see that control valve data sheet, whether then check whether this control valve is type is linear or quick opening or equal percentage, whatever it is, you will select according to that and see what is its CV, valve coefficient. Then you will select CV and specify that CV value over here, then size. So these are basically the part of the dynamic simulation activity. So in dynamic simulation, we will use basically pressure flow theory, that is very basic thing, that PF theory, that we call as a PF theory. When we do the dynamic simulation, then pressure flow theory comes into the picture. Here we will define only pressure, then rest of the thing, here we will define the pressure drop, then it will go to the expander. The expander, inside the expander we will be using its all the curves, then its outlet will be going to somewhere with certain pressure. Then again there will be valve, we will be providing the pressure drop across that valve for that much flow rate, accordingly we proceed. So this is very, even this sizing of this valve is very very tedious task. If you go to this dynamic tab, then you will add the strip chart. Then strip.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you cover one example of control valve also? The sizing part in your exercise, like you are doing for pump compressor. Can
okay,
you
okay.
include one?
Okay, sure. That we will take later on.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
See the thing which you are asking is that we are doing by using this interface. Okay, that. Just remind me. Sometimes we will discuss.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So now only 7 minutes remain. Okay. So, in the dynamic simulation activity basically performed mainly for the OTS purpose or some other kind of study. Otherwise, nobody is doing the dynamic simulation.
Okay, sir.
Now let's cover the next topic, that is our heat exchanger. Heat exchanger part, so many people are familiar about the heat exchanger, but in high seas, whatever activity we are doing, same kind of again and again, I am repeating. As a process engineer, our objective is always to mainly focus on the process condition. So many equipments are there for which you will be deciding, you will be fixing your inlet and outlet condition. In between goes to the scope of the others, like vendor, suppliers scope, this kind of activity. Likewise, when we are doing the heat exchanger simulation, in heat exchanger simulation, we are talking about the heat exchanger. In simulation, if we are talking about the heat exchanger, that means we are providing the input for the shell side as well as tube side or both sides. In high seas, you will find heat exchanger, then cooler, then heater, and some other like LNG exchanger you will find. If we are talking about the heat exchanger, that means there will be one shell side and one tube side, and you will be providing the information about the shell side as well as for the tube side. But if you are talking about the cooler or heater, then in that case you will be fixing your process side condition, that my process my temperature was 150 degrees C and I want to cool it to 50 degrees C, then by using the cooler unit operation in the high sys, you will fix the outlet temperature. And if you want to raise the temperature of any stream from 150 to 200, and you will use the heater operation, then you will fix the outlet temperature. One thing. Second thing is, you know by using which stream we are going to heat this stream, or by using which stream we are going to cool that stream. If those kind of information we are having, then we will select the shell and tube. So once I will open the high sys interface, we will show. In heat exchanger case also, there are so many options available to simulate the heat exchanger. One thing is simple endpoint. Second is rigorous shell and tube. Then simple steady state rating. Then simple weighted. Then dynamic rating. I think as of now, it is just like story. We will not be able to understand more about this. So what I will do? I will create a case in the high sys. Then see what is the significance of the endpoint. What is the significance of the rigorous shell and tube? What is the significance of the simple weighted? And what is the significance of dynamic rating? So once we will open the high sys interface and just we'll define the shell and tube side streams condition, then we will select the one heat exchanger, and inside that heat exchanger, when we select the its model, whether it is simple endpoint or rigorous shell and tube, whatever it is, that we will discuss over here. Simple, we are having in this case we are having very simple hot water at 250 degrees C and 1000 psig to heat a cold stream of water in a shell and tube heat exchanger. The inlet and the pressure of the cold stream is 25 degrees C and 130 psig respectively. The outlet temperature of the cold and hot stream is this much respectively. And if flow rate of the hot stream is 100 kg per hour, determine the flow rate of the cold stream passing through the exchanger using the pressure drop for both shells and tubes at 50 kPa. So let's go to let's disconnect once more, only 2 minutes remaining, and I will connect, then we will start from fresh. Okay.